Vande jagat karanam, Vande pannaga bhushanam shashidharam, Vande vasunam patim, Vande surya shashanka vanninayanam, Vande mukunda priyam, Vande bhakta jana ashrayam chavaradam, Vande bhakta jana ashrayam chavaradam, Vande Shivam Shankaram. Friends, by this time, all of us must have been familiar with the four streams of yoga. The one is Raja Yoga, in which our willpower is strengthened. We have the will, we have the determination, we have the decision-making capacity. It is already there with us. Mysteriously, it has become weak. Now, by the practice of yoga, our determination, our firmness, our decision-making capacity will be strengthened. So, Raja Yoga is nothing but strengthening the willpower, intensifying the determination, making the decision-making capacity much more powerful. We have it, we get it strengthened. In Jnana Yoga, we have the knowledge, and this knowledge should be full. It will be full when we know the truth, truth of everything, and the truth of life and death. When we know the truth, then there will be no problem. Jnana Yoga clarifies our intellect, sharpens our intellect, makes our intelligence very bright so that we can understand everything, especially the truth of everything. Third is, we have love in us. This love is body-centered. This love is selfish. This selfish love, body-centered love, is to be purified, is to be ennobled, is to be made unselfish. It is to be made divine. When it becomes divine, noble, and gets purified, that is Bhakti Yoga. All of them we offer at the feet of the Almighty Sharanagati. When all these yogas are translated into action, it's called Karma Yoga. You cannot see determination, you can see the determined activity. You can see a man of firmness. You cannot see intelligence, you can see intelligent man. You can feel the intelligent expression. You can feel the intelligent action. Intelligence cannot be seen. Intelligent words, intelligent writings, intelligent actions can be seen. Love cannot be seen. Loving words can be heard. Loving actions can be seen. Loving persons can be seen. Loving deeds can be seen. Self-surrender cannot be seen. We can feel it. We can enjoy it. All these can be seen only in actions. When those actions are available, it's called Karma Yoga. Karma means action. In English, the word karma, when it is translated, it means only action. Action means activity. Activity means movement. In this entire world, nothing is unmoving. If I say the time is 7:31, I am wrong. When I stop this statement, the second hand is here, By the time I complete this statement, the second hand has moved. Time is moving. Earth is rotating. Sun is becoming brighter or less bright. We are aging. Everywhere we find movement. Everywhere we find change. Change is activity. Activity is action. Action is karma. All of us are doing some work. I am sitting and talking. Action. You are sitting and listening. Activity. The time is moving. Change. Activity. Therefore, Krishna says, Nahi kaschit kshanam api jatu tishyatya karma krit. In this world, in this prakriti, in this nature, in this universe, nothing is unmoving. Everything is moving. In our body, there is movement, pulsation. It's movement, change, action, blood circulation. Blood is not stagnant, it is moving. Heart is pumping. Blood is going inside, coming outside. Inside there is movement of blood. And you have the breathing. We take the breath, we leave the breath. This is movement. We think, movement of the mind. When we live, it is movement of the entire body towards the future, body, mind, intellect, equipment. Finally, when it dies, death is also an activity. Dead body, is it stagnant? No. Even the dead body bloats, begins to smell foul. There are insects, germs created. Nothing remains as it is. The change may be slow, the change may be fast, rapid, gradual, steady, but there is nothing without a change. The entire universe, we are also like that. When karma is action, action is taking place incessantly, continuously, endlessly, non-stop. Every action produces a reaction. And action is one karma, reaction is another karma. If you take action as a ring, reaction is another ring. This action produces one ring. Actions are neither good nor bad. If you say one activity is good, I say the same activity is bad. For example, killing is good when on the battlefield. Pakistani fellow is coming, Indian soldiers are standing, they both fight, and the soldier from India will be given Bharat Ratna or Padma Vibhushan if he kills 1,000 people. It is good. Same thing, killing in society, it is hatya, murder, he will be punished. Killing is good on the battlefield. Killing is bad in the society. Action becomes good or bad depending upon my attitude. Marriage is good. Marriage is bad. To whom? To a particular person. To another person it is bad. Marriage is like a city bus. Crowded city bus. There are people waiting in the bus shelter. And the marriage bus comes. The man in the bus shelter wants to get into it. He wants to get married. The married people already in the bus, as soon as possible, they want to get out of it. Both are good. What is wrong? What is right? Depending upon your attitude. A student fell in love with a girl. He could not marry her. He became mentally deranged. He was admitted in Nimhans, Bangalore. I went to see that boy. I asked the doctor, what is wrong with him, poor fellow sir? When he is doing BSc or MSc, he fell in love with a girl and that girl did not respond. He became mad. He is treating the doctor. Next to bed, there is another young, handsome, dynamic, gem-like boy. That boy is also mad. Why is this boy mad, sir? That girl he married. By marrying one, a person became mad. By not marrying the same woman, another person got married. So where is right, where is wrong? Where is good, where is bad? It is attitude. Killing is good, killing is bad. So action has a reaction. Actions are neither good nor bad. It depends upon the attitude behind. Similarly, action has a reaction. Reaction is also good. Reaction also is bad. A boy wrote the love letter. He gave it to his girlfriend. For the first time, she found him to be bad because he gave the love letter. Till then, he was only a boyfriend. Now that he gave the love letter, she got angry. She took her right foot chappal, gave a blow on the cheek, and this man says, wonderful, beautiful, excellent, she has respect for me, she loves me, that's why she has taken the right foot chappal, otherwise she would have taken the left foot chappal. It is the attitude. He considers her to be loving. The reaction can be seen as good. The reaction can be seen as bad. The sum and substance from the philosophic point of view is, actions are continuously taking place inside, outside. No action is good, no action is bad. Every action has an equal and opposite reaction. No reaction is good, no reaction is bad. All actions are rings. If you have good attitude, bright attitude, it is a golden ring. If your attitude is different, it is an iron ring. If your attitude is painful, it is a barbed wire ring. Any number of rings. Gold rings, silver rings, copper rings, barbed wire rings, actions are of various types, all are rings. And the reaction is good, reaction is bad, reaction is favorable, reaction is unfavorable, ring after ring after ring after ring. Life is a continuous chain of rings, actions, reactions. Good, bad, painful, pleasant. Arjuna, O man, you are caught in these actions. Then what is the way out? How can I be free from the chain of actions? I am imprisoned, I am able to understand. In this life of long activities, actions and reactions, I am chained. What is the way out? Then change your attitude. How to change my attitude? I will give you a simple episode. A huge temple is being built. Many stones are required for the foundation and the construction of the temple. Stones are being brought from the hills, rocks. And there are many stone cutters. They will make it rectangular. Points. And so many stone cutters are employed. They are taking the hammer, they are chiseling, they are cutting, 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 right from 8 o'clock till 5:30 in the evening. They are go on doing the activity of cutting the stones. The temple is given to a contractor. And now that contractor is visited by a media person. Sir, I want to interview your workers, interview your stone cutters. Yes, welcome. So the contractor came from TV9, the interviewer, media person also has come. They went to one stone cutter, and this fellow, media person, asked him the question, how do you find your work, sir? Then he looked at him, karma. When my father asked me to go to the school, I did not go. In the college, I failed again and again. My mother was telling, don't fall in love with anybody, and I fell in love with a useless woman. We married, we gave birth to a dozen children. I don't have any source of income. Because of my past karma, I am reduced to a stone cutter. My friends are IAS people, IPS people, IRS people. They became process magistrates. It is my fate. He is cursing, grudging, cutting the stone. Attitude. Second stone cutter, they went. He said, sir, these people are paying only 100 rupees per day for the stone cutting. You may be going around the entire country. There may be a church being built. There may be a mosque being built. There may be another house being built. Please tell me if anybody is giving more than 100 rupees for the stone cutting job. This is the only job I know. Dear TV9 gentlemen, dear contractor, please get me a better result. Cutting is same. I shall cut these stones, but I want more salary, more income, more benefit. Then they went to the third fellow. The third fellow was asked, he gave his attitude. Please, I am very, very happy, very comfortable. I am cutting this stone. I am making it perfect. And it seems a huge temple is going to be built here. After 10 years or 15 years, the huge temple will come. Hundreds and thousands of people from all over the world will come. They will look at the temple. I am glad I am given an opportunity to build a huge temple. Thank you, sir. I must thank God. His attitude. One fellow is grudgy, reluctant, and another fellow is working for more money. The third fellow, blessed I am, I have the opportunity. Then they went to the fourth man. He said, please wait. It's not the time. He is busy cutting the stone and sharpening it, brightening it. Every point, every corner, very carefully he was doing the work. Very quickly he is doing the work. Very perfectly he is doing the work. The TV9 man, please don't disturb me. Contractor, please disturb, don't disturb me. He is absorbed in the work. The work was completed. The contractor gave him 100 rupees. He did not count, he put it in the pocket. Then the TV9 fellow asked, how do you feel? Wonderful. Excellent. That's all. No other comment, he went home. He gave that money to his wife. Observing this man's absorption, commitment, involvement, next day the contractor came and he gave him 500 rupees. He did not count. He put it in the pocket. He went to his house and gave it. Third day the contractor came. Sir, you are a very perfect gentleman, sir. I give you the job of giving the finishing touches to the stones. You need not work from 8 to 5. It is enough if you give the final touches. Okay. And he gave him 1,000 rupees. He did not count. He, whatever work is given, he does. He does not demand more. He is not dissatisfied with anyone. He is happy. Shraddha. Shraddha in doing the work. Involvement in the work, commitment, not interested in the degrees, not interested in the titles. That does not mean he is not opposed to them. If it comes, Kedrucha Lava Santusto, whatever comes, I accept it. I am not at all bothered about the fruit of action. And that is Karma Yoga. If you go to Mahabharata, one incident, the great yuddha is taking place, about to take place with between Kauravas and Pandavas. On Pandava side, the chief of the army staff is Drishtadyumna, the brother of Draupadi. On the Kaurava side, Duryodhana is breaking his head, who should be the chief? One after the other he thought. And finally he went to Bhishma and told, sir, you should be our chief army general. Bhishma said, yes, thank you. But I should have freedom. Yes, sir, you are free, sir. Then he started distributing the work. Drona has this responsibility. Shalya has this responsibility. Shakuni has, one is brigadier, another is a captain, another is commodore. One by one, he was giving. All the top people are given the duties. Karna is not yet given any duty. He was burning. You are not the SP. You are not the DSP. You are not the circle inspector, you are not the sub-inspector, then what? Constable. Karna got angry. As long as this old man is the chief of the army staff, Mr. Duryodhana, I shall not fight. Who is the loser? Duryodhana. What happened to your friendship? Then Bhishma says, Mr. Duryodhana, if you make me the chief, this is my arrangement. I have my reasons for making Karna the constable. Simple man, small man, because he has hundreds of curses on his head. Therefore, he is unfit to occupy the highest position. Please make him the chief, because you love him, he loves you. I shall work any post given to me. If you want me to be the watchman, I shall be the watchman. If you want me to stand near the chapel stand giving tokens, I will do that. It is not what you do that is important, it is how you do that is important. When our activities are governed by the right attitude, it is called Karma Yoga. All of us are here in Prashanti. How many of us love the work we do? How many of us reluctantly come to Maitrimilan? How many of us lovingly come to Maitrimilan? How many of us are benefited by Maitrimilan? How many of us enjoy it? Life is to be enjoyed. Life is never a botheration. Life is never a trouble. If you are a Karma Yogi, you will enjoy the life. Every action is divine. Nothing is mean, nothing is noble, everything is similar. This attitude Sri Krishna advocates in Bhagavad Gita. He asks Arjuna, be thou a yogi, tasmat yogi bhava Arjuna. May you be a yogi, that is, whatever activity I am to do, I do it with utmost shraddha. There is nothing like a hateful action, nothing like an unwanted action. Every activity is wonderful. Just eating is good, worshipping is equally good. Sweeping is good, adorning God is also good. Decorating the hall is good, cleaning the kitchen is good, toilet is good. Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa went to the lowly placed people and he cleaned their toilets. Everywhere Karma Yoga is to be practiced, then every activity of ours will be wonderful, most satisfying, most involving us, and we enjoy the activities. Having come to Prashanti, let us understand the spirit of Karma Yoga. Let us do every activity with Shraddha and let us not be worried of the fruits. If only we perform the actions with the utmost Shraddha, we become Karma Yogis. Now let's meditate on that Yogeshwara Sri Krishna.